Hi, this is Halectronics. In this video I will present you and also build a circuit with the TR-072CP amplifier IC on a breadboard. I will make several variations in the components to see what changes at the output with the help of my oscilloscope. First I will make a circuit using dual supply voltage, then later I make another one with single supply voltage. First I make a short presentation of the IC. The TR-072CP is a low noise high input impedance amplifier IC packed in DIP 8 package. Here I show you a short description of the IC and here are the characteristics. This is a JFET input amplifier IC, which means the input impedance is very high as you see here. Let's start building the circuit on the breadboard. I'll use my dual-array 12V toroidal transformer for power supply, a small diode bridge and two pieces of 1000 microfarad smoothing capacitors. The gray wire is the ground and the two blue wires are the AC. I connect the gray wire to one of the bus strip and the blue wires to the AC leg of the diode bridge. This way the power supply circuit is done. Using this red wire, I connect the positive supply voltage to the pin 8. The purple wire will be placed between the negative supply voltage and pin 4. The power supply connections are done. The TR-072CP is a dual amplifier IC, which means that two amplifier circuits are packed in this IC. In this video, I will use the pin 1, 2, 3, which is on this side. I'll use my amplifier in unity gain setup, which means that I put a wire between the inverting input, pin 2, and the output, pin 1. The next component is the input capacitor, which is a 470 nanofarad monolithic capacitor. I connect it to the non-inverting input, which is the pin 3. After that, I place a 22k ohm pull-down resistor, which helps to eliminate noise. Notice that I don't place it after the input capacitor, instead I place it before. In the next variation, I will place reverse. The capacitor will be ahead of the resistor. The audio connector comes, which later I will connect to the phone. Every time before I start up the circuit, I check the supply voltage. This time it was too high for this amplifier, so I decided to use two pieces of 100 ohm resistors at the positive and also at the negative supply voltage. This will work as current limiter and also drops the supply voltage. I connect this green wire to the output, which is the pin 1. Notice that I don't use capacitor or resistor at the output, I simply start a circuit and measure it. I place another wire, which will be the output ground. With the help of my phone as a function generator, I start to examine the amplifier circuit. As you see, I have to set up the oscilloscope to measure AC, otherwise it is hard to see the signal because of the high DC voltage. In order to have only AC at the output, I have to place a capacitor to the pin 1. As you may know, the capacitor blocks DC and only AC can get through, which can help to get rid of the DC at the output. I placed this 2.2 microfarad bipolar capacitor at the output and also a 22k ohm resistor, which will be the load, otherwise still there will be DC at the output. I connect the green wire again, but now after the capacitor, and I power up the circuit. It works well, I have a clean sine wave at the output, but still I want to do some changes and more tests. I took off the components of the breadboard except the power supply components and I start another variation. I place the input capacitor to the same place, but the 22k ohm resistor I connect one end between the capacitor and the amplifier and the other end to the ground. The amp will be in unity gain setup same as before. I place a 22k ohm resistor directly to the output pin 1 and only after that the output capacitor. I know this is not the correct order, but I was curious if the output will be stable. I connect everything back again, the oscilloscope and also the input connector for the phone. I do get a stable and clean output as you can see, but I want to make one more modification. I put the resistor which is at the output after the capacitor as you can see and it is working well again. Here's the schematic for you so you can also try it. Next, I will show you how to build a single supply circuit with this amplifier IC. I move the wire from the negative supply voltage to the ground. For the single supply setup, the datasheet recommends a voltage divider using two 10k ohm resistors to add the DC voltage at the input. I do as shown in the datasheet, but I use another 22k ohm resistor because I already have one which is connected to the ground. So this means that I will have a pair of 22k ohm resistors to make the DC offset. It's done, I just connect everything back up again and test it. As you see, the results are good again, the sine wave is clean. Here's the schematic for this version of the circuit. The problem with this setup is that if the supply voltage has ripple or it's not clean enough, then the amplifier can pick up the noise. A very small amount of ripple is already enough to have hum or noise at the output, so I had to come up with a solution. I tried to use linear voltage regulator, namely the 78L05, which was an excellent choice. I used this circuit in my other project when I had to add the filter preamp to the iPhone iPod docking station. You can watch the video here or on the link in the description. Thank you for watching. If you have any kind of question, feel free to ask in the comments and don't forget to like my video and subscribe. Have a good day.